Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class we will be dealing with the Tata Cyrus conflict or Tata Cyrus issue. Very important for public administration optional students, for management optional students, and also important from general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 3 point of view. Now this issue basically relates to the conflict between Cyrus mistry, unceremonious expulsion from the post of chairman of Tata Sons, and this is also about the corporate governance. Now in order to understand this entire issue, we need to understand three contours. The first contour being, we need to understand certain terms related to Tata's. We need to understand what is meant by Tata Sons, and then we need to understand Tata Trust, and then we need to understand the functioning of the companies under the Tata Group, and then we need to understand what led to the conflict between Cyrus mistry and Ratan Tata, and thirdly we need to understand something about corporate governance and the ethics involved in it. So this will also help you in general studies mains examination paper 4. Now let us start from the first thing. What is meant by Tata Sons? Now all the companies that are working in the name of Tata, they are being controlled by Tata Sons. So Tata Sons is a collective body of the shareholders which is managing the entire Tata Group. So there are hundreds of companies under this Tata Group. They are in the sphere of producing salt, they are in the sphere of producing automobiles, they are in the sphere of software, they are in the sphere of watches, manufacturing watches, they are in the sphere of steel, they are in the sphere of power, they are in the sphere of technology. So there are multiple sectors in which this, over which this entire Tata Group is spread. So the net worth of the entire Tata Group is around 110 billion. So this is the projected one. Though when the Cyrus mistry joined as the chairman of the Tata Sons, the net worth was around 115 billion. And by the time he was expelled, its net worth was 130 billion. So the total net worth of the group has come down. So Tata Sons, it deals with all the setups under Tata Group. Then what is meant by Tata Trust? Tata Trust are the various types of trusts created by the Tatas. These are the philanthropic trusts, Jamshedji Trust Group, Ratan Tata Trust Group, and certain trusts created in the name of the forefathers of the Tatas. Now these trusts, they hold about 60% of the share in the Tata Sons. So the entire group, it is the 60% of the share that is being held by the Tata Trust. So basically this is a group in which majority of the shareholders are the Tata Trusts. So Tata Trust, they also have the power to remove anybody from the post of the chairman of the Tata Sons. So basically Tata Trust, they have a lot of power in themselves. They have entrusted a lot of power in themselves. Now before Cyrus mistry was appointed, a change was done how the Tata Trust can manage the functioning of the Tata Sons. And in this management thing, a specific clause was added that this trust will have the power to remove the chairman of the Tata Sons. And this is how they've exercised their power, and they've removed Cyrus mistry from the post of chairman. Now there are various companies working under this Tata Group. There are companies operating for hotels, there are companies dealing with salt, there are companies dealing with information technology like TCS. Now, anybody who is the chairman of the Tata Sons, ipso facto means by itself also becomes the chairman of the multiple companies existing under Tata Group. So by virtue of this clause, under the governance structure of the Tatas, Cyrus Mistry was also appointed as the chairman of the various companies, like chairman of the hotel groups of the Tatas, chairman of the TCS, the chairman of the Tata Cars, the Tata Automobiles, etc. Now, in the mid of the October, he was removed and Ratan Tata became the interim chairman. And Ratan Tata should have also taken over the chairmanship of the multiple companies existing under Tatas. But this could not take place. This transition was not easy because Cyrus Mistry had decided to assert his right as per the corporate governance ethics. Now, as per corporate governance ethics, any corporate institution that is being established, it should not be protecting the rights of a dominant group, but it should also protect the right of the multiple stakeholders. So Tata Sons, according to Cyrus Mistry, is not the property of the Tatas, is not the property of Ratan Tata and his family. Rather, it should be carrying its functioning as per the corporate governance rules. And as per that rules, there is a quarter of people who are supporting Cyrus Mistry as the chairman of the various companies working under Tata Sons. Now, it is the Tata Hotels Limited members have already decided that the Cyrus Mistry should be continuing as the chairman of the Tata Hotel Limited. Then the most important thing to understand here is about what led to the conflict. Conflict hua kyun? There are two reasons because of which this conflict unfolded between the Tatas and the Cyrus Mistry. The first reason is the mishandling, the mismanagement of the Docomo Tata telecommunication services issue. Docomo Tata telecommunication services issue. And the second is about Tata steel setup in London. Tata Steel company functioning in London. So there are two issues. Pehla issue hua telecommunication services ko leke. Second issue hua Tata Steel corporate working in England. Now first of all, let us discuss about this Docomo and Tata telecommunication services. Now this Docomo company, it belongs to Japan and it had invested about in 27% of the shares of Tata Telecommunications about 6 years back. Now it has invested around rupees 12,000 crore. This is the tentative amount I'm telling you, not the exact figure. So Tata Telecommunications mein Docomo ne 12,000 crore rupay invest kiya. Aur jab ye invest kiya, jab investment mein ek important clause tha ki agar Docomo chahe to wo apni investment wapas le sakta hai. Jitni usne investment ki hai, usse aadha usko mil jayega after a period of 5 years. Agar 5 saal mein wo jana chahe to wo ja sakta hai, but it has to pay, it can take away just 50% of what it has invested. In the initial phase, Tata Docomo had invested about 12,000 crore rupees and it wanted about 6,000 crore rupees back. Very, very important thing. And when it had bought the shares, 27% of the shares in Tata Telecommunication, it had brought at the rate of about rupees 117 rupees per share. And 5 saal ke bheetar mein agar usko paise nikalne hote, to it could have taken it at the rate of rupees 58 per share. So this was the amount by which it could have taken back its share. But meanwhile, there was an RBI guideline according to which any company that want to withdraw its operations from India can withdraw by taking the amount only as per the market value of the share at that particular time, not as per the stipulations as per which it had entered into an agreement in the past. ये नहीं है कि पिछले हिसाब से, पिछले rules and regulations के हिसाब से, पिछले guidelines conditions के हिसाब से आपने जो agreement किया है उसके हिसाब से पैसा वापस नहीं निकाल सकते. अगर आपको पैसा निकालना है तो उस समय की जो आर्थिक condition है कंपनी की, उस value क्या है उस समय share की, उसी के हिसाब से आप हिंदुस्तान से पैसा निकाल के लेके जा सकते हो. So in 2014 when this Docomo began to ask for its money, at that time the value of the share was just around rupees 27 to 28 rupees. So it was just about 3000 crore rupees that was to return to Docomo. But Ms. Cyrus Mistry, he has not dealt with this issue effectively. Now this issue also went to London arbitration court. Now from London arbitration court, it was said that the India should be paying what it was decided in the agreement, in the contract between the Tatas and the Docomo. And this was also filed in the High Court. But it was the mismanagement of the Cyrus Mistry due to which Tatas have already supplanted about 8,000 crore rupees and still the dispute cannot be resolved. And the second issue is about the mishandling of the steel operations of China, of Tatas in England. When Tatas bought this entire steel network in England, at that point of time, the steel sector was performing very good. It was in a healthy condition. But due to the meltdown of the global economy, the fortunes of the steel companies of the Tatas, it dwindled. The fortunes was lost. And at the same time, the steel prices, they have also begun to come down in China. And then China began to dump steel in England. And this was one of the reasons why Tata's steel operations in China, in England, could not yield result because of excessive dumping being done by China. And Cyrus Mistry again could not revive the steel operations. So basically it was a kind of a failure. It was the heat that the Tata Group was facing. It was the dwindling of the profits of the Tata Group that led to his expulsion. But again, he is trying to assert himself as per the corporate governance ethics and corporate governance rules. He has brought the case before NCLT, National Company Law Tribunal. Now, it is the National Company Law Tribunal that will be deciding about the fairness and the unfairness involved in the expulsion of Cyrus Mistry as the chairman of the Tata Sons. So in order to read more, read Brainy Map on the same current affair issue, and you can also read more notes on this, and you can find this notes and Brainy Map on brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Baba, take care, have a nice day.